Nathan Zagura here at Empower Field at Mile High, where the Browns had a must-win game against the Denver Broncos, but unfortunately, they came out on the wrong side of this one, losing 24-19, and now find themselves at 2-6 after the first half of the season. They have now lost four games in a row, and for the Browns, it had been turnovers and penalties. Well, this one, the Browns had one takeaway. Joe Schobert forced the fumble. The Browns did not give the ball away at all. They won the turnover battle. The Browns were the less penalized team in this one. Only five penalties compared to seven for the Broncos. And yet Brandon Allen, in his first NFL start, was able to go up and down the field on the Browns and get his team into the end zone. The Browns, five trips into the red zone in this one. They scored one touchdown, they had three field goals, and they had one turnover on downs. The Broncos, they didn't even have a single trip to the red zone. They didn't need it. Big play after big play after big play. A 21-yard touchdown to Cortland Sutton opened the scoring. Then they found Noah Fant, the rookie tight end, down the sideline for over 70 yards and a touchdown as bad tackling really popped up and hurt the Browns in this one. So the Browns found themselves down, but they had 12 points in the second quarter. Three trips in the red zone, three field goals, added a field goal from outside the red zone. Austin Seibert staying perfect on the season on his field goals, and they were down at the half. In the second half, though, it was Philip Lindsay, again, another chunk play, a 30-yard run that would put Denver up 24-12 at that point. The Browns would come down the field, they would get a touchdown to Jarvis Landry and to make it 24-19. After a defensive stop, the Browns had a chance to get down the field again. But the Browns had lost a challenge in the second half, and they had to use two timeouts to avoid delay of game penalties over the course of the second half, including one before the fourth down play on that final drive. Baker Mayfield's pass would fall incomplete. The Broncos would get a first down, and because the Browns had no timeouts, were able to run the clock out from the two-minute warning all the way down with three consecutive kneel downs. The big plays victimized this team, much like they did week one against Tennessee, where the majority of their offense came from a few big plays. That was really the story today. The defense couldn't avoid giving up those big plays. Tackling was an issue. But offensively, it's going to come down to execution and in the red zone. Too many trips, too many unfulfilled trips, not getting in the end zone. At one point, they have two touchdowns, you have four field goals, they're ahead. That was the story. In the red zone, the Browns could not get the job done, including one time where they ended up turning it over on the Denver 5-yard line. They went for it on 4th-and-1, a quarterback sneak for Baker Mayfield. Looked like it might have been a bad spot. Nothing clear on TV, couldn't overturn it. The Browns would turn over, then Denver would go the length of the field to go for that Lindsay 30-yard rushing touchdown that ultimately sealed the Browns' fate. I gotta tell you, you thought if you came in here, Brandon Allen, first NFL start, if you came in here, you won the turnover battle, you won the penalty battle, you didn't beat yourself, you'd say there's no way the Browns would lose this game. And unfortunately, that's exactly what happened. The big E, execution, in those critical moments, third downs, red zone, they were not there for the Cleveland Browns today, and that's why they sit at 2-6 after what can only be considered an incredibly disappointing and disheartening loss here in Denver, the one that the Browns thought they would get to get this season turned around and get it going. And unfortunately, now they are 2-6, four games under 500, having losing four in a row, and will face the Buffalo Bills at home looking for their first home win of the season in what is, again, a must-win game. For the latest on your Browns, keep it tuned to ClevelandBrowns.com and the Browns mobile app.